Hi, I'm Hazel, and this is a guide to the 2017 Midsummer Fire Festival holiday event in WoW. From June 21st until July 5th at 10 a.m. Pacific Time, you can light fires, put out fires, level more quickly, and most importantly, collect a big bunch of pets, toys, and transmog. So if you're all caught up from previous years, here's what's new in 2017. There is a new battle pet called the Igneous Flameling available to purchase on the holiday vendor for 350 blossoms. His moves are suitably fiery with Burn or Flame Breath, Stone Skin or Immolation, and Conflagrate or Rupture. The Flameling is cageable, so you can farm extras to sell or skip the blossom grind by purchasing one in the auction house. There's a new toy added in 2017 called the Set of Matches, which you can buy for 500 blossoms. From the looks of it, it sets you on fire. Who would have known? For the first time in 2017, holiday cosmetic items can now be transmogged during their holiday. That means until July 5th, you can prance around in your Midsummer set. Wear it to world quests, wear it to the Tomb of Sargeras, wear it wherever you want. The holiday boss Frostlord Ahun will drop his weapon enchant as an illusion on his regular loot table. If you want to pick up Illusion Deathfrost, just queue for the boss repeatedly until A, it drops, and B, you win the roll. I hope you've got some time. For the first time this year, Ahun no longer requires max level. You can now queue for him at low levels, so if you're nowhere near 110 and you still want to try for his loot, you can. And that more or less wraps up what's new this year. Even if you're all caught up, Midsummer Fire Festival is also a great time to level alts. Stop by a ribbon pole in a city or town and twirl your way to an hour-long, 10% experience buff. You can go back for that as often as you like during the event, and it does stack with heirlooms. My favorite way to do it is to just park myself by the pole, spam Q for dungeons, and then re-up my buff in between. Also leveling related, at the holiday vendor, you can purchase heirloom upgrade items with blossoms. If you've got your heart set on some midsummer loot, you're going to need to collect some burning blossoms. Honoring the bonfires of your faction will give you 5 blossoms per fire, while desecrating enemy flyers gives you 10 blossoms. If you do a full lap of both, you're going to get just shy of 1,000 blossoms to spend. The daily satchel of chilled goods from queuing for the boss will give you between 5 and 15 blossoms per day. Doing all of the dailies will give you another 20 per day, and there's a total of 42 available from one-time quests. If you're still coming up short on how many blossoms you need for your shopping spree, remember that you can use alts to do all of this multiple times. The collectibles are all account-wide, so by using one alt for each one, you could get everything on the first day if you're keen. If you're new to the Fire Festival or missed a couple years, here's a quick recap of all the collectibles that you can get. There's a total of 4 battle pets. We have the new Igneous Flameling for 350 blossoms, the Frigid Frostling drops from the chilled goods that you get for killing Ahun every day, the Spirit of Summer can be bought for 350 blossoms and looks kinda like a little fiery wisp spirit. Last, the Blazing Cindercrawler is an elemental spider that you can get, also for 350 blossoms. All 4 of these pets are cageable, so buy and sell them on the auction house as you please. There are a total of 4 toys to add to your box. New this year is the Set of Matches for 500 blossoms. The Burning Defender's Medallion will also cost you 500. You can get a Cozy Bonfire for 350 blossoms, and the ever-popular Brazier of Dancing Flames goes for 352. For year-round transmog, you can pick up the Frost Scythe of Lord Ahun from the Satchel of Chilled Goods. The 2 event tabards, Summer Skies and Summer Flames, are moggable year-round too. Last, for whatever reason, the Crown of the Fire Festival is also permanently available to transmog and does not require an armor type. If you need a halo to top off one of your sets, and you totally do, this is the one. During the event only, you can mog the Sandals of Summer, Vestment of Summer, Mantle of the Fire Festival, and Helm of the Fire Festival. The helm actually serves as a cooking fire when you kneel down, although it seems that the use effects are not available when the item is mogged. All the pieces of the Midsummer Mog are sold for blossoms on the holiday vendor. For completing the Midsummer meta achievement, Alliance players can get the Flame Warden title, while Horde gets the Flame Keeper. That achievement is required for the Long Strange Trip meta achievement for the Violet Protodrake. The Midsummer meta basically boils down to visiting a zillion bonfires and juggling torches really well at least once. So, that is the 2017 Midsummer Fire Festival. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you think. Please consider subscribing if you'd like to see more WoW videos like this, and have a wonderful, wonderful day.